Hey everybody, my name is Shefa Noor and I'm part of Bijli Agency. In this video, I will be going over custom task types within ClickUp. This is a fairly new function within ClickUp and it's very powerful and allows you to categorize your work within ClickUp. This can really be used across different use cases. It's really valuable to different industries, but I will be showing you how you can use it for development work specifically. Let's jump in.
All right, so I'm currently in my ClickUp app, and I have built out just a mock development space where I'll be showing how powerful the task types feature in ClickUp can be. So the way that I've built out my development space is I have three lists, one where I'm managing my backlog, one where I'm managing my current sprints Kanban board, and then a stand-up schedule where I'm managing my meetings. Now, where I'm going to show the use of task types, so I'm currently in my backlog list. And you'll see I have a lot of different views that I have up top here, and it's because I'm managing a lot of different types of work right within my backlog. So the way that I'm doing things here is I have my epics, I have my stories, I have my bugs, and I have my tasks. So there's four different types of work that I am managing within one list, which is very powerful and I would say pretty different in the way that ClickUp has been used in the past, at least. So if I click over here, there's usually the idea of adding a task. But if I click on this drop down, you'll see we have task, which is a standard ticket type within ClickUp. We have milestone, which is also a standard ticket type. But I've created these four ticket types as custom ticket types within ClickUp, which is bug, to manage all of my bug tickets that I receive within development. My epics, which my bugs live within. My meetings for any meetings that I want to manage for my team, as well as my stories for any development work. So I have the way the hierarchy works is I have my epic, which is my high level function or feature that I'm developing. And then under it is going to be my development work, any bugs that I see, and then tasks specifically for that epic. All right, so that is my hierarchy. Here in my list, I can see that within this list, I have only filtered out to see high-level epics. So I'm able to see this is my first epic, this is my second, and this is my third. And if I click on this little expand, I'm able to see all of my tasks that I have within my epic. So I don't have a lot of work built out, but just for the demo, if I open epic number two, I'm able to see, all right, I have bug number one and dev story number three slated for this specific epic. These two epics are prioritized, and this isn't to do. If I go into my all tickets, I'm only showing my actual work that I need to do. So it's not showing my epics, but I'm able to see what epic my work is related to. So if I open my bug ticket, I'm able to see that this is part of epic number one. So it allows you to still have these relations, but be able to have this separated out view of only the actual work that needs to get executed. So I have my bugs here. I have my stories here. I have this filtered so it does not show me my epic. So if I come over here and I add a task, if I want to add a standard task, I would just be like, all right, this is my task number one that I have to do. So if I hit create task, there you go. Now we're able to see our tasks, our bugs, and our stories. What's really nice is I can also create work within my epics list. So if I'm a project manager building out the work that I need for my different epics, I'm able to come in here. I'm able to say, all right, for epic number two, we have another ticket. So I hit this plus sign and then I change the ticket type here to story. So if we know we need to do dev story number 17, just putting the random number out there, I change this to development to story. I hit save. And then I know that I need to create a bug too. I have this bug issue that I need resolved, bug issue number 18. I change the ticket type to bug. I go ahead and it's save. All right. So I can start building out my work under this epic. And what's nice is if I go into my all tickets, I'll see that these tickets start to get auto-populated here because I am still in the same list, just have a different view of only showing the actual work. So I see bug issue number 18. I see dev story number 17. So everything that I'm building out when I'm in my epics view is showing when I'm in my all tickets. If I go into my board, this is just a visual that shows all of the tickets that we have and where they are within our backlog. Now, if I go into my bugs, I'm only seeing my bugs. If I go into my feature requests, I'm only seeing the actual development work. So it kind of allows you to have these different visuals of, you know, all of your work. So it's kind of categorizing and breaking out, making it more bite-sized, allowing you to have that separation of work type. And like I said, this could be the same thing now if you're working in digital marketing. Rather than having the story, rather than having the bug, you can have content writing, you can have, web changes. So whatever type of digital marketing you do, you're able to kind of customize this to your liking using the task types function within ClickUp. All right. Now, if I go into my Kanban board, you'll see really the same thing. I'm able to see all of my work here. So all of my dev story, my bugs, my tasks, they're all showing here. Now, this is grouped by priority. If I wanted to see this more as, you know, where are my development tickets versus where are my bug tickets, I can have this group by task type. And once I do that, I'm able to kind of see that, like, okay, I have one task, one bug, and four stories that I need to work on within these next 2 weeks. And if I go into backlog, what's also nice here is once I'm ready to pick something up, say, for example, I'm like, all right, bug number one, we're ready to pick this up. It actually gets moved out of the backlog and it gets moved into the Kanban board. So if I come back into my Kanban board, I will see bug number one here now. Okay. So this did get moved over. Whatever content I had, the sprint points, as well as any description, is also going to map over. Now, the last thing I'll show here is the stand-up schedule. Here, I have a list of all of the meetings that I want to have across my stand-ups. And I have a different ticket type I'm using here too, which is quite nice because it allows me to have that separation. This is a different type of work. These are meetings. So same thing here. I can click add a meeting. And then if I have a specific like PMO management meeting, I can, you know, make that the title, put in my information, who the requester is, if it's for a specific initiative, what the ceremony is. I can, you know, set it to sprint review, and I go ahead and hit create meeting. Once I do that, that gets created over here where I'm able to see PMO management, and then I can set a date for it, and then I can also have it set to recurring. So if I have this every month, I'm able to, you know, have that reoccur every month as needed for my PMO management meeting that I have. Now, the other value of this is, like, with the different task types I'm using across my different lists, so I'm using meetings within my stand-up schedule, I'm using epics within my backlog, I'm using stories, I'm using bugs. In my development, I'm also able to have views here. So now if I, and, you know, for people that are new to ClickUp, this development space, when I click on this, it's going to show me an aggregated list of data from all of my different lists. So if I want, in this high level view, just a calendar view of my meetings, I can go ahead and click add calendar. And what's really nice about this is I can filter this out so that the task type is only meetings. And once I do that, I'm able to see all of my meetings, right? So I have my sprint planning, sprint review. So you have this calendar view of what your stand-ups look like. So this is a very powerful tool just because it allows you to see a lot more in one specific list than we were able to do in the past. Let me know if you've used this task type function within ClickUp, what your thoughts are on it, and how you think that you can use it for your team.
Thank you guys for watching. And remember, I did go through development work as a specific use case, but know that task types can be very valuable to different types of work. So if you're in the marketing space or in the construction space or any other space that you're using ClickUp for, really try to find the value of using task types to manage your work. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below. Don't forget to subscribe, and you can visit our website at bijli.org. The link will be in the description below. Thank you.